I've got a lot of history with this SX3 slug gun. I've killed several big bucks with it. In fact, I shot one of the biggest bucks of my life. He's a Boone and Crockett 5x5, great big bodied animal. And when that time came, there is no gun and slug combination that I would rather have than this setup, and I'll tell you why. In this specific gun I'm shooting, Winchester's Partition Gold, 3-inch, 385 grain slugs. So when you think about shooting a big bodied animal, would you rather shoot him with a 150 grain bullet or a 385 grain sledgehammer? And I shot that buck working a scrape and it just hammered him. But you have to understand what gun to use where. For example, these slug guns are used all across the Midwest. In a lot of states, you have to use slug guns, and they have their right place at the right time. And I'm going to give you some examples. If you are hunting in the timber where your shots are inside 100 yards and you've got thick cover around you, there's no better setup than this. This is a brush buster. If you got to shoot through some briars, some small saplings, that you definitely want to shoot one of these slug guns with a very heavy slug. That's going to allow you to, you know, bust through that brush. Can we set up a slug gun for all around hunting in the timber, hunting on the field edge? Absolutely. And this gun is a prime example. I'm shooting a Swarovski Z3 with a BDC reticle. If you look at your ammunition box, it's going to give you your drop. Okay, so this is just a reference. This is going to give you an idea of what the bullet's going to do at different distances. But what you need to do is you need to shoot the gun. If you spend some time shooting your gun and understanding it, you can make it work for a variety of different setups. For example, this gun's good out to 150 yards because I've taken the time to set up the BDC reticles. So it's 0 at 100. I'm using my next reticle at 125 and my next reticle at 150. Now, just like we saw on the box, it's going to drop off dramatically when you start shooting further out than 150. Now, I can shoot further, but what happens is not only do you have that drop off, but my pattern's starting to open up. So let the gun help dictate to you what the distance can be. Okay, so different guns are going to shoot different slugs differently. So keep that in mind. Winchester makes a variety of different slugs. I chose this particular one because it's what patterned the best out of my gun. I shot every slug they made, and then I found the one that made the best, tightest patterns. And fortunately for me, it was of the 385 grain. I like to shoot a heavy bullet when I can. But please understand, if it wasn't patterning well, I would shoot whatever was patterning the best. Sometimes we fall in love with, I want to shoot this bullet because it's the best. The best bullet is the one that shoots the tightest groups. Just remember that. So you may buy another SX3, grab these Partition Golds, and it may not pattern well out of it. Grab some Super X, grab some Copper Impact, and find the slug that patterns the best with your gun. That's very, very important. Now, here's an advanced tip, and this is not going to work for everybody, but when you can, buy your ammunition by the case. Because what I found is this box might be 3 years old. If I run out of these shells, I go to Cabela's and I buy another box, they may pattern different because of, you know, just how they were manufactured, so on and so forth. So if you can buy your ammunition by the case, that's the best, because for most people, that'll be a lifetime supply. So if you take your time, you shoot your gun, you understand its capabilities, what slug fits best with that gun, you're going to be far more successful in the field because you're going to understand what you can and cannot do with that gun. Now, if you're up on a timber ridge and you got close quarter shots within 100 yards and you got to bust some brush, there is no better combination than this Winchester slug gun with these 385 grain slugs. I can promise you that. And I have example after example to prove it. I've done it, and there's no gun that I'd rather have. If I'm going in, sitting in a tree stand, it's the rut, and I gotta stop a buck chasing a doe, that's the gun I want in my hand.
Yeah, I know exactly what deer that is.